Concert. As you can see in your program, it's appropriately titled A Nordic Winter. And in tonight's concert, you'll hear a variety of music which features both living and past Norwegian composers. That was the father of much of northern Nordic music, but specifically Norway, Edvard Grieg. The program will feature two other very famous currently living composers, Kim André Arnesen and Ola Gjeilo. This program is part of a four-part series throughout the Quincy Choral Society's concert series. If many of you were probably there in September where we gave a concert at the new dedication of the Quincy Common, which featured a lot of American music. Here, tonight, we're featuring Norwegian music, March, Celtic music, and then rounding out the season with Brahms' German Requiem and some more German music. One of the things that's spectacular about working with choirs and musicians is we get to come together and work together on projects. But what also is great is that we can have a moment to step into another culture's shoes, to experience what makes this culture unique, rich, and why people are so proud of it. Norwegian music is something very near and dear to me, as it's where many of my ancestors are based and come from. And particularly at Christmas time, we're proud of our Norwegian roots and sing many carols, not only in English, but also in Norwegian. And most of the food which we eat is Norwegian. So I hope you enjoy tonight's program. We're honored to have some representatives from the Norwegian Honorary Consulate in Boston, including Terry and his wife and some friends. Welcome, Terry. Thank you very much. The program is based largely on Arnesen's Magnificat, a seven-movement piece of music, which is for choir, strings, piano, and organ. Many of these musical aspects drawing on traditions of Norwegian music, as you just heard the Greig and the string writing, which he is so vibrantly known for. We have divided the Magnificat into three sections throughout the program, as you will see, interspersing different carols, both for the choir, some more string writing, and a few carols, which we hope you will join us later on in the program. Thank you all for being here. Enjoy. For the next piece on the concert, I hope that you will please join us in singing one of my favorite Christmas carols, I Am So Glad It's Christmas Eve. This may be a new one to many of you here in New England, but it's a staple in my family, and if you'd please stand and join us, I would greatly appreciate it. Thank you. In the middle of the program. First in Norwegian.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That first third of the concert prominently featured the female voice, as you saw throughout, a variety of different movements, reflecting that of the young Mary. In the same scene, now we shift just slightly, going back to Greig, and we see another part of the Christmas scene, but this is the animals and those gathered around. Thank you.
Thank you.
The text for our next piece of music comes from the wall of a concentration camp. It's a very simple yet very moving poem, accentuated knowing the location of which it was transcribed. The text is, "I believe in the sun, even when it's not shining. I believe in love, even when I feel it not. I believe in God, even when he is silent." Very recently, there was an accident and we lost a young gentleman from our community, a high school senior, somebody who was very involved in the community here with a variety of different activities and was known as a leader and a charismatic young gentleman. The senior passed away, unfortunately, much too young, and we want to dedicate this next piece to him. This personally touches me and the choir, as the gentleman was in a Boy Scout troop, and the picture of him, his father, and the troop sits in the room where we rehearse every week. Additionally, the gentleman was a senior, had just received his acceptance letter to Worcester Polytechnic Institute, a school where I teach at. He hopes to go there next year and be an engineer, or to another school. I hope you think of him, hold him in your memory and your thoughts as we sing this next piece, and also to many of those who, for this holiday season, is tough as they deal with loss or loneliness or things that hold them back throughout the year. We ask that after you hear this piece, you refrain from applauding and continue to reflect as the strings play one more piece. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
join us again for Lo, How a Rose.
Thank you.
Before we launch into just the last few pieces, I want to recognize somebody that's very special to me and to the chorus. As you can see in your program, if you've looked through, our wonderful, very talented accompanist, Gingy Grimes, is celebrating her 25th year with us. She's the person that holds this whole thing together.
Just
To close our concert, we'd like you to join us one more time. And for those who you don't know, and just to mark it, Silent Night, our last carol for the evening, was written 200 years ago this Christmas. So think of that as you join us for this last piece. Please stand.
Thank you very much for joining us tonight.